Og nu der turnerer han land og rige rundt med Danglish 2, som er efterfølgeren til det første Danglish show, som man kan finde på TV2 Play.
And on that note, Nadim, we should talk some English with Conrad Molden to see if we are good talking to him like that.
I think it's very unattractive if we are going to pretend like we can speak English.
Because we can in our heads, but we cannot if we talk to a real person.
Exactly. In praksis, it's not a good thing. Så lad os lige hurtigt skifte tilbage til dansk.
Ja, lad os gøre.
Fordi hvis man vil opleve Conrad Molden, så er han blandt andet at finde i Åbenrå til april måned. Han kom også forbi Højer i maj måned, og for et par dage siden, der var han så i Kolding og spille. Men vi har snakket med Conrad Molden lidt tidligere på dagen for at høre ham om, hvorfor i det hele taget flytte fra England til Danmark.
It's a very good question. You know, it's not as exciting as I wish. I actually put free masters into Google many years ago.
Okay.
And I found a candidate at Aarhus University because I heard that you can study in Denmark for free.
Oh yeah, and get money from it.
And get money. So it's something crazy, 90,000 kroner for 1 year back in the UK. So I thought, you know, I would come and abuse the Danish state system. And then I just fell in love with the place. And don't worry, now I've paid enough tax that I made, you know, it's balanced out. We broke even, me and Denmark. We're friends again.
Okay, sounds about, sounds great.
Yeah, it's a new friendship, you know. Denmark used to hate me. I think the government, Inger Støjberg, used to hate me, but now it's okay.
And how big is the English comedy in Denmark? Because Simon Talbot is trying to get big in the USA, in the United States, with English comedy. But you are trying to get big in Denmark with English comedy. How big is their competition for you?
Well, firstly, it's really sweet of you to compare me to Simon Talbot. That's amazing. But also, I mean, with my friend Jakob Tarnhoy, we started an English language weekly show in Aarhus called English Stand-Up Comedy Aarhus. And that is every week, and it's gotten really popular. And that grew into another open mic in Copenhagen at the ICC Theater. So right now we have weekly shows in the two largest cities with tons of Danes and internationals coming to perform. And that has also led to the growth of new comedians, you know. So there are English language shows that internationals and Danes are going to. So it's getting pretty big.
And how is the Danish audience, the crowd? Do they understand you at all?
Sometimes I've done, especially early in my career, when nobody knows what I do. I've done shows in places like Sunnyland where people were a bit confused.
Okay, Conrad, tell me more about Danglish 2, because you are coming to the southern part of Jutland again, Højer, Åbenrå, and also Kolding. What can people expect?
It's a mashup. So I've been here for 7 years now. So it's a lot of my experiences of living in Denmark and my struggle with the Danish language, but it's also mixed with this new element, which is that I became a dad. So, you know, taking my son to Volgestuen and trying to understand the crazy raising a child system. Because before, when I didn't understand Danish, it was okay. You know, that was just my problem. But now it's like my child's education, you know? So they're telling me things about my son, and I'm just nodding and pretending that I know what's going on. So it's my... So Danglish 2 is really kind of update on my life. It's much more story-based, and the experiences that I've had. The first show is a lot more kind of just wordplay and little imaginary stories.
And what do you expect about these venues here in our part of the country? Because you talked about Tønder earlier, that it could be a little bit hard to understand you sometimes. What do you expect about these venues?
I think the Sønderjyske and Menske are extremely friendly. I did a show in Hellerslev about 2 weeks ago, and that was fantastic. And I've never performed in Åbenrå before, so I'm excited for that. And Højer, I've done a couple of times before, and it's an amazing venue, really, really nice people.
If you are gonna rate us at our English language the past 5 to 10 minutes, what do you think, honestly?
I think I give you... Well, if we were at Lærdansk, you would have passed your P3 exam.
That's good. That's good.
Absolutely. You're now British citizens, actually. You know, the passport, I don't know if you've seen since the end of January, it's now worthless. So we just give them away, so you guys get British passports.
Okay, yeah, thank you.
Yeah, enjoy, and for your families, friends, whoever, anybody that you can get to actually go there now. So,
It's funny because we a few weeks ago we went to London to do our radio show over there and to watch some Premier League football at the Olympic Stadium. Yeah, and it was the day after Brexit.
It was, wow.
Yeah.
Okay. How was that?
It was actually pretty quiet.
Yeah. I imagine there were a lot of people at the airport leaving.
Maybe.
Everybody just out of the country.
I think in the airport they were more worried about coronavirus than Brexit, actually.
I love it. That's fantastic.
But the last question is, if we are ever going back to London, if we can get in again after Brexit, what should we see that isn't a tourist trap or London Eye or Tower of London and all the things we have seen a million times? Do you have some favorite places or hidden secret places you can suggest?
For a real flavor of London, I would say you need to go a little bit out of the center. I live in an area in the southeast, which is kind of in the suburbs, and it's not like you would go there for a pleasant experience, but it's real London. And that is where you will see people eating, eel and mash and just weird pies and smoking cigarettes, all of that stuff. Like real, real London and the local people who you can't understand what they're saying.
Ah, okay.
So, they have three teeth and one eye and they, they try and sell you a car radio, those kind of people.
Ah, okay. Yes. That sounds hyggeligt.
Yeah, it's the British version of hygge.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. Just make sure you can always feel where your wallet is in your trousers.
Conrad Molden, it has been a pleasure talking with you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Globus Radio. And I look forward to being in Sunderland and the rest of the country. And you could go on conradmolden.dk and find out all about the tour.